Welcome to Tokyo, where ancient tradition lives on amongst 21st century bustle. It's the 43rd Artistic Gymnastics World Championships. Tokyo Tower dominates the skyline, but it's the superb gymnastic performances that will be the focus of attention. A city of 13 million people, its beautiful night skyline, that sets the backdrop for a thrilling competition. The last three men's gold medals of this World Championships will be decided today. We have, of course, high bar and parallel bars, but we begin with the most explosive event, the vault. And Thomas Bouet, the reigning world champion, Anton Golitsukov, they'll provide the fireworks, and watch out for Haxion Yang, who has a very, very special new move. 25 years old now, Thomas Bouet. Look at that qualification score, 16.62, and that's an average. So he has some incredible work. The reigning world champion on vault. The reigning European champion on vault. And that is why. A double front with half turn, the Dragulescu, absolutely centimeter perfect. What an unbelievable vault. That's for starters. High, turning clean, spots the landing and doesn't move. A terrific score, 16.666. Now then. What more in the locker from Thomas Bouet? He qualified massively on the 16.62. Now then, it'll be big. Double pike. Oh, I thought he was going to fall, but he didn't. He wrestled extremely well. He landed with his shoulders way behind his feet. How he kept his balance. Goodness only knows. He really had to work hard. Lovely in the air. There's the double pike. Shoulders back. Ooh. And he wrestled it to keep his feet. But that is going to be expensive. And the door has creaked open for anyone to grab this title now, because that will cost him. Very well struggled. But in the end, he'll lose marks. He did. 15.708, 16.187, the target for the rest. The next gymnast is World Championship silver medalist on vault, Anton Golitsukov. Thomas Bouet, a little bit disappointed with that, but Anton Golitsukov, he's won a bronze at World Championships. He's won a silver. Could this be the moment? He qualified in fifth. You can see the scoreboard on the left indicates that he's going for a seven vault. Opens with a double pike. Very, very good vault indeed. Just a pace to the side, and what a challenge that will provide. Double pike from the Arabian. Very nicely done. Very nicely done indeed. 16.333. And look at the execution mark, 9.333. So Golitsukov, now then, keeps that up. He has a 16.187. That's the mark given to Thomas Bouet. Now then, Golitsukov. Aggressive run. And spins his way around. Half turn out of the double front. Very, very solid vaulting. And watch this technique. He turns early to make the turn. Finds the ground. This is almost like a side somersault at this phase. Really, that's a challenge, and Bouet knows it. gone into the lead. The average 16.366 with a 16.4 for the second bowl. Standing at the end of the runway, Hak Seon Yang. Can he make history for the most difficult recorded vault at a World Championships? It's worth a massive 7.4. Hold on to your hats. Here we go. Look at the run. And he made it, a triple twisting straight front Southope from handspring. Look at the contingent. They're absolutely delighted with that. But he has to get his focus because it's 2 volts in the average. But look at this, handspring. Beautiful style in the air, a triple twist. Lovely lockout from the contact on the horse, through the shoulders, lovely line through the body. 3 times around the vertical axis, that's some vaulting. Look at the score, 16.866. So he's done the most difficult vault ever seen at a World Championships. Now, he has to nail this one. It's another triple twist, and this time backwards. Surely that's good enough. Amazing vaulting from Hak Seon Yang. Look at this. Triple twist, this time in the other direction. Sixteen, two six six, and the average 16.566. Unbelievable. And a little weight on the shoulders of Makoto Okiguchi. He qualified second. 16.187 was Thomas Bouet's score. He's in third at the moment, but it could all change now. Another triple twist. Very good opener. Lots of enthusiasm. Yamamuro amongst the crowd there. Just a tiny pace back, but look at him spinning around like a top. 16.3, this is incredible standard of vaulting. Okiguchi going for a medal, but he has to find another 16 plus vault. Question is, can he do it? Golitsukov in second with a 16.366. 2.5 twists that time. From the handspring front, very, very secure vaulting. They think he's done it, look. Great stuff, good thrust from the top of the horse. 2.5 turns. Open with a triple. Second vault was 2.5. He's gone into third, 16.291. A bronze medal, surely, for Makoto Okiguchi. And look at that, jubilation in the Korean camp. Hak Seon Yang makes history with the most difficult vault ever seen, 16.566. The Korean takes the gold, Anton Golitsukov the silver, and Makoto Okiguchi pleases the crowd with a bronze for Japan. Unbelievable vaulting. 18 years old he was, and this is Golitsukov, another silver at world level, and a very popular bronze for Japan, Okiguchi. He's made history in a superb vault final. Korea, Russia, Japan. Parallel bars up next. Very interesting final. Two Chinese, of course, in the line. And the Chinese will be challenged by Yan Kushera from France. And Kohei Uchimura makes another appearance. Vasilios Solikidis, well, he's been around a long time. And here he is, the first we see qualifying down in eighth. So he's got to do something here. He has his own move in the men's code of points. He is an innovator. Back cuts, nice swing to handstand. Uprise, and that's lovely. Diamandov with extra turn. That's his own move. And that's another one of his. Uprise, immediate Makuts. This is lovely stuff from Solikidis. He's got long lines and really uses them well. Oh, he's so high in the pike to upper arms. A lovely double pike. He's found something special in this final. Qualified down in eighth, but you can bet he'll move up. That's his own move. Uprise, immediate Makuts, Solikidis. The double pike, high, pretty much spot on. ...15-5-3-3... First place at the moment, Vasilios Solikidis. Now then, Danel Leva qualified in six with 15-3-6-6. Now, he's impressed us with how he treats the parallel bars. It's continuous. From this moment, the swing will be unbelievable. Look at that. A flourish. Full turn and again. It is superb. Under somersault, the handstand. Bail, full turn. Oh, 1.5 turns. That time with full turn. Another long swing. The Diamandov slightly overcooked, but he's swinging non-stop. That is beautiful. Danel Leva, and yes, the release after the tension, he is absolutely thrilled with that. So we should be. 6,000 other people in this arena were as well. Unbelievable stuff. Keeps the swing. 1.5 turns in the giant. The double pike at the end, wrapped tight and rock steady. Look at that, the release of tension and energy. And there's Stepdad. He always gives it max. Usually see him celebrating on high bar, but he's got something to shout about here. And how? 15-6-3-3. He's delighted with himself. Come on, he said, I can win this. Danel Leva in the lead. Delight in their camp. Zhang Shenglong. Now he qualified in third, 15.4. Used to seeing him swing on high bar. But he's very, very solid on parallel. Look at that. That's a lovely start. On the pike front somersault, swing to handstand. Under somersault with full turn. Under somersault without turn. This is lovely technique. That time with a half turn. Two giants, one with a turn and one back to handstand. Diamandov slightly overcooked, but it's good. Nice and high in the 1.25 straddle. Lovely high shoulder in the heely. Big double pike. Oh, and I thought he'd nailed that landing. He just was too deep. Yeah, tiny shake of the head. But bat is so, so high, feet together before the hands make contact. That's the sign that it's right. And this was peculiar. It looked to be absolutely nailed. He couldn't get his shoulders up. 15.533 in second. Leva out in front. Zhang second. Solokidis has matched that score, so there's two in second at the moment. Koei Uchimura qualified fourth, 15.391. Yeah, a little bit deep, tiny bit soggy there on the back cuts. It'll be a deduction. That's lovely. Half turn in the under semi. Oh, expensive that. Wrong shape with the pace. Back under control. Nice double tuck. That time, double pike. Swinging well, but the start, two moves, could be expensive. Nice double tuck again, this time from straight arm support. Half turn from the giant. I tell you what an exhibition. Never mind the mistakes at the start. That's a lovely finish as well. And gold in the all round. Gold on floor. And tiny little effort there. He bent his arms and the back was a bit arched, but knees locked together on the double saltos. Great landing. There's Mum. She supported him all week. Of course she has. Oh, 15.5 out of the medals. Well, you've got such a fabulous attitude. Well, look at the celebration there. Danel Leva, incredibly innovative on that apparatus. Leva for the USA then. He takes gold. And great to see Solokidis take his first silver at world level. And sharing that with Zhang. And Kohei Uchimura misses out. Golden performance from Danel Leva. Superb to watch. A share in silver, 32 years old. He shares that silver with Zhang from China. Solokidis, Leva and Zhang, our medalists. The event that every gymnast dreams of winning. It's the Blue Ribbon event. Fabian Hambuchen has got a great pedigree. Junior and senior European champion. World champion in 2007. Epke Zonderland's going for broke. So this should be a great nail-biter of a final. Hambuchen, who qualified in third with a 15.5, his father Wolfgang putting him onto the apparatus. Many of these gymnasts can get well into the sevens on difficulty. Incredible work. Tiny little shuffle across the bars. First big release. The Coleman, the full twist in the Kovacs, safely done. Here comes the Kachev. Into the Rybalko, immediate combination into full twist in front. Super. Stauder, Rybalko, that 1.5 turns from the Stauder swing. Oh, almost lost the handstand there. Safely through the Yamawaki. Nice little hop in the quast over the top of the bar. This is crucial. Just a little hop back in the double-double, but Hambuchen, and that's the first to go. Teammates delighted. Look at this. Full twist in the Kovac. This very, very good high bar. Extremely difficult. What have they given it? Qualified with a 7-4. Yes. They're giving it a 7-5 this time, 16-2-3-3. And that is going to take some beating. The pressure really is on. Zhukai. 15.166 to qualify. Now, he has done in Doha at a World Cup Series event. He's done a 7-7 difficulty with an 8-7 e-score. That's a, so he's capable of 16-4. Looking very clean at the moment. Easy in the one and a half turns into the full twisting front. Such lovely lines. One and a half turns, a little bit ragged with the legs. There's the full. Makes the Yamawagi. Very quick hand change to set up the forward swings. Nicely in the heely. Good combination into the straight front. Incredible stuff. Big wind up. Oh, and an immaculate finish. A bit deep, but he did not move those feet. Lots of excitement in the Chinese camp. It's super to watch. That's the only time you could see that his legs were a little bit out of control. But what a fantastic routine from Zhukai. Now, I told you, he's capable of a 7-7. Yeah, high five indeed. 7-7 difficulty, 16-4-4-1. An immense performance from Zhukai. The reigning high bar champion, Zhang Shenglong, has just seen his teammate get the highest ever difficulty score and score on high bar at a World Championships. Now then, nice in the catch-up. Confident in the Rebelco. Squats in, a little bit late on the turn, but rescues the Yamawagi. And he kept his legs together in the very difficult Stauder Rebelco. This is lovely. Oh, the crosshand from Kachev. I tell you, we're treated to some fantastic high bar. And the combination, a little bit piked. So the judges will not give that a stretched salto forwards. He'd be down on difficulty. But it's all relative, and that dismount was superb. It'll still be very highly valued in terms of D-score. But the pike instead of the stretch, yeah, 7-6, one below Zhukai in second, 16-3-6-6. And a fitting closure to this World Championships. Kohei Uchimura, double gold medalist, individually, did it all round, did it on floor, and he will step up his difficulty. Fabulous. He did it without the twist in qualifying, so that puts him in the sevens for difficulty. There finds the one and a half turns. Squat, half turn, out beautifully. Oh, yes. Straight catch-up. Keeps the swing. Squat, full turn, it's late, but he still makes the Yamawagi. Endo, hop out of inverted grasp. He's not finished yet, I can tell you. Oh, puts the full twist in the Kovac. This is amazing. What a way to close the competition. Stand it up. He does, and the roof comes off. That was amazing. Uchimura, triumphant three times in a row in the all-round. Took a gold on floor. Here he is. Look at the kick out on that. Unbelievable work. Double twisting, double straight, as easy as you like. Flares the arms out for the landing. Superb. Well, might you be pleased. Savour the atmosphere, young man. 16-3-3-3. Oh, and he's delighted. He's got a bronze to go with his gold on floor and his gold all round. Look at that. genuinely a nice guy. But what an incredible performance from Zhou Kai. Nicky Sunderland in the background, didn't make the medals. Zhou Kai, a wonderful gold. Zhang takes silver. Uchimura comes in at the final curtain to take a bronze. A fantastic World Championships. Couldn't have finished any better. The spectacle, the thrill, and the danger of high bar negotiated by these three medalists. And that man closed the show incredibly well. The end to a superb World Championships. Zhou Kai takes the final gold medal. Zhang and Uchimura take silver and bronze.